Abbots Ford Tower is closed until 1500 Zulu. All aircraft contact Cranbrook radio on 119.4. Abbots Ford Tower.
Good morning, you guys. I am so excited today because I've been wanting to do this video for you guys for a really long time. I'm out here with Simon again. We're out super early in the morning. The sun's just rising. I was hoping for a little better light, but this is gonna be just amazing. We're up at Mount Robbie right now, and we're just gonna come by this ledge landing here. Today's exercise is gonna be on overpitching a helicopter. Let me give you the definition of overpitching. Overpitching is when we demand too much power out of the engine, and the engine just simply doesn't have enough power to keep those blades spinning at the speed that they're supposed to. That's a long definition. So we're gonna practice this. Now, I've entitled this helicopter, Why Helicopters Crash When Overpitched. There's a reason for that. If you don't do things perfectly on your approaches, when you're right on your power limitation, the helicopter can crash very easily. I'm gonna show you today the fine line between doing a perfect approach and landing safely, or doing it poorly and potentially having the helicopter crash. So we're gonna come around, Simon. Let's go set up an approach. We've assessed the spot. We know the spot's good. I'm gonna fly with you for a quick sec here.
And is this settling with power here or what?
No, okay. So three definitions to talk about. I'm not gonna talk about them all today, but we're talking about overpitching today. That's very different than settling with power. Settling with power is coming in with too much mass and inertia. This is also different than vortex ring state. Three different things. I'm gonna do videos on settling with power and vortex ring state another day, okay? So we're coming in on our approach here now. We've assessed that our winds are out of the north, and so I'm gonna come by here. I'm setting up my approach really shallow, and I'm making sure that I get close to my spot so I get a really good sense of what that wind is doing. I'm gonna slow the helicopter down, and I'm actually gonna get it into a hover right beside my spot here. And I'm making sure that when I do that, I have enough space so that if I don't have enough power, if I run out of power, I can bail out, okay? So now here, I'm gonna simulate us. We're very close actually, right on the border of power, but we just have enough. I'm gonna simulate us running out of power. So when I roll off a little bit of throttle and I droop my rotor RPMs, that's simulating running out of power and overpitching. And all I gotta do is turn a little bit, lower the collective a little bit, and fly away. Those are the two key points. Immediately, turn away from your spot, lower the collective. Lowering the collective flattens the pitch of the helicopter, or flattens the pitch of the blades, and that immediately recovers power, okay? So that was the first two key steps. I turn away from the spot, I lower the collective, that's gonna get my power back. The rotors are gonna start spinning at full speed again, and immediately I fly away from my spot. It's that quick and easy, you guys, to recover from your spot, okay? This one here, I've checked my power. I know that we're on our power limit. This is a perfect example. We're right on our power limit, but we do have enough power. So this next step, I'm gonna come into this approach. We're going for the real approach this time. I'm gonna come in quite shallow, but a little bit higher than my spot. And I get to what's called commitment point. Right now I'm at commitment point. I do not slow down, I do not stop, and I continue my movement all the way in, all the way in, all the way in. I've already pre-chosen my landing spot, and I'm gonna come in here and go straight for landing. And there we are in the landing. Okay? Now, I wanna just talk about a couple quick things here. So once you're in your spot, let's pick it back up into a hover here. Once you're in your spot, I can take my time. I don't need to land the helicopter immediately because I'm in what's called in-ground effect, okay? So there's a difference between out-of-ground effect and in-ground effect. In-ground effect is when the helicopter is within about 15 feet of the ground. Let's just call it something simple like that, about 15 feet of the ground. It's actually within 2/3 of your rotor disc. And so within about 15 feet of the ground. So I'm in ground effect right now, and the most beneficial in ground effect is usually within about 2 or 3 feet of the ground. And so I'm actually getting a ground cushion with my rotors. The rotor blades are pushing air down onto the ground. It's creating kind of like a pillow of air underneath me. And so I'm actually using less power to hover here. So right now I'm actually using 92% power to hover in ground effect. Now when I was out over the edge of the cliff there, I was out of ground effect. That means I have no ground effect underneath me. I was hovering with 100% power. I had no reserve power whatsoever, okay? And so now I can take my time, I can look around, I can even maneuver a little bit if I have to, and then I can choose my perfect landing spot, which is not right there. Move forward a little bit more, and that's probably going to be my spot right there. Beautiful. And there's my landing. All right, little seating check to make sure I'm on the ground nice and safely. All right, Simon, did I miss anything?
No.
Perfect.
No?
Yeah. Okay, perfect.
Gun was open. You're so afraid of getting bored with so bad. It's a different life.